Let's say that you walk into my room. A few things will pop out at you. First, the computer workstation with wires scattered about. Then some Star Trek posters, a phaser, other assorted tech pictures. And prominently sitting on top of my dresser sit a Lego crane, Millennium Falcon, and City. This, in reverse order, shows the progression of interests in my life. Simple creation with Legos led to an interest in sci-fi and later engineering. It all started with Legos, for me and millions of others. For some scope, let's hear some fun facts. Over 500 million people grew up playing with Legos. There are currently 100 pieces per person in the world, which makes well over 700 billion total. And currently, 100,000 Lego pieces are made per minute. So what makes Lego so popular? Simply put, they spark our imagination. 6 2x3 pieces, these little rectangles, can be put together in over 915 million different ways. Once you get to 10 pieces, the number is technically finite, but it hasn't even been found, so it's infinite in human practice. Furthermore, Legos are relatively cheap and basically unbreakable. Pieces made in the 1950s are still compatible with modern pieces, and many are still in use today. This yellow piece is my dad's from the 1970s, and it still fits perfectly with these modern pieces, even though I had to pry it off of a set last night with a wrench. But it's not just the existence of the product that makes Lego such an icon. In the early 2000s, the company was losing money quickly because it acted like it was just another toy maker. To save itself, Lego had to realize what makes their product great. As in my experience, Legos can be used as a tool for engineering. Around the time they were losing money, the company had just come out with a kit called Mindstorms, this motor set I had. Practically overnight, these devices were used in classrooms to teach programming and robotics. At Legoland and other places, Mindstorm robotics competitions propagated. Thousands of kids, including me, were introduced to engineering for the first time. Beyond primary school, Legos can be used as a tool for real work. MIT famously uses them in some research labs, like city planning, and some architecture firms use Legos to make models of their buildings. Amazingly, a working car, life-size home, and 112-foot tower have been built with nothing more than the plastic bricks. These fantastic Lego creations demonstrate the system's other key feature, its universality. The car is from Romania, the house is from England, and the tower is from the United States. Because so many people are familiar with the system, Legos unite makers everywhere through the worldwide AFOL community. It stands for Adult Fan of Lego. These adults meet at Lego's online forums and at unofficial brick fairs held across the world. They can communicate across numerous language barriers because, like a picture, each set tells its own story. You don't have to speak Romanian to appreciate how awesome a working Lego car is. Many people argue whether English or Chinese is the universal language. In many ways, Lego is more universal. Certainly, it is the universal language of creativity. Schematics for a set don't contain words, only pictures, so any maker can share his or her creation with anybody else in the world. The only requirement is the parts to complete the project. The rise of Lego stop-motion movies only expanded the product's storytelling capabilities. The search on YouTube turns up everything from a minifigure version of Michael Jackson's Thriller to slapstick comedy. And the Lego movie, which had relatively low expectations before it came out, became an instant favorite of kids and their parents, and it was nominated for an Oscar and a Golden Globe. Clearly, you can tell any story with Lego. It might sound like I'm lauding Legos as the solution to all our world problems. I know they're not. But that doesn't mean we can't learn from the small brick. So maybe you'll consider a humble plastic building material the next time you're on the market for a house or car. I leave you with this.